Hey, what's up everybody? It's B-Hub here, and today we're going to review the top 10 legendary list that I put out a couple weeks ago. You sent in your comments, and I pored over them. I deeply considered, I analyzed what you had to say and the suggestions that you made so that I could bring you the new top 10 legendary list. Here's what I'm going to do at the beginning of this video. I'm going to list the previous top 10 list, and then in the description of the video, I'm going to list the new top 10 list if you just want to see who the heroes are. Now, if you stick around, I'm going to review why I put the new list together, why heroes came off, why heroes went on, and why heroes that you suggested might have not made it onto this list. So I hope you stick around to hear my reasoning as well, but let's get right into it. So what I'm going to do is list the previous list. I'm going to list it from 10 to 1. So starting at 10, we had Shinimari. At number 9, we had Sir Nick. At number 8, we had Ray. At number 7, we had Nethril. At number 6, we had Longbeard. At 5 was Warlord. 4 was Prince Kymar. 3 was Venus. 2 was Martyr. And 1 was Bad L. That's our previous list. So now let's start talking about who the new heroes are going to be and if anybody stayed or if anybody left. So the first hero that we're going to discuss is going to be our new number 7 hero. So here's a quick note. I think the first 1 through 6 heroes deserve to still be in the 1 through 6 spot. I think they're all very strong, very solid heroes, and I'm happy to keep them where they're at. It might change in the future. We will see. But let's get into the new number 7. Number 7 is a Banner Lord hero, and his name is Septimus. Now, Septimus has a very similar ability in his passive that Warlord has on his A1. Now, the passive is this. Each attack has a 30% chance of increasing the duration of all debuffs on a target by one turn. And then his damage increases by 30% if the target's HP is over 50. That's awesome. That works on Clan Boss a lot. But really, we're focusing in on him because he has the ability to extend the duration of debuffs. That means your decreased attack stays longer. It means your poisons can stick around another turn. Your HP burn can stick around another turn. This is amazing to have on a hero. This can make an entire team and make your team so much stronger and deal way more damage to have a hero like Septimus. In addition to that, his A2, the damage is based on the enemy max HP, so his A2 deals a lot of damage to Clan Boss as well. These heroes are few and far between. That's why they're so rare in the game, and that's why he's all the way up at the new number 7 spot. Now, that's going to mean that Nethril is going to be pushed back to our number 8 spot. And let's kind of discuss the difference between these two kind of heroes. So Nethril is on this list because he can deal all of this poison damage, which means he deals a lot of damage on Clan Boss. He also has some good arena abilities in his A2 and A3, which I think are great and can really help. But his A1 is really what made him onto this list because of the damage he can deal to Clan Boss. Now, I want to reserve at least one spot on this list for a Clan Boss damage dealer because it is a really important part of the game to deal all of the damage. But that kind of hero can be switched out with other heroes that deal amazing damage as well. For instance, I know many of you suggested that Xavier should be on this list, but here's the thing. I'm happy to switch out multiple heroes in this number 8 slot, the Clan Boss damage dealer slot. Many heroes have the potential to deal plenty of damage. Xavier deals poison on her A1, she deals poison on her A2, and she also has some good arena abilities. Another hero could be this new one. Krutraxa, I think that's right. She deals 4-hit A1, which ignores 50% of enemy defense. Her A2 plays as a weaken and grants an extra turn, which means every 4 turns, she's going to get 5 attacks in one round. That's strong. And she can revive herself, which is also good. I need to see the sample size, though. I want to see how much she can actually do in a fight. But she's also a potential damage dealer. In addition to that, in Banner Lords, you don't have anything. In High Elves, you have Elnari here, who I'm still not 100% sure if I ever pronounce these heroes' names right or not, but you get the point. He has the ability to attack an enemy and places a burn debuff that he just places, and it can't be resisted. So that's 100% uptime on an HP burn with poisons on his A2. All of these heroes can deal amazing damage to Clan Boss, so I'm okay with subbing in your favorite damage dealer. But really, I think this, the spot remains the same. We can't put all of the damage dealers on the top 10 list because really there's just too many of them. There's plenty of heroes, whether they're epics or whether they're legendaries, that deal a ton of damage. So I'm just going to put one of them on this list. I pick Nethril. You could pick something else. That's no problem. Now, the next hero, we had Rey. Rey, I'm just going to move off of the list. I don't think that Rey should be on this list as a top 10 hero. I'm a little biased. I think she's still a great, great hero. But I would move her really to 11, and I might actually move her to 12. We'll talk about that in a second. But first, let's deal with number 9 and number 10. We're kicking Sir Nick, and we're kicking Shinimari, this hero right here, off of the list. I think they're both solid heroes. If you saw my video, you know that I think that they perform particularly well in Arena. But I want to talk about heroes that I think are even better in Arena, but also better in other areas. Now, 9 and 10, you can flip them around. I think they're both really solid. I don't have them in a particular order, but they're both on this page in the High Elves already. One of them is Lyssandra. Now, Lyssandra is great. She offers a speed boost in all battles, which I think is amazing. That's a solid speed boost in any kind of battle. That's a good aura to have. But her A3 is what is amazing. Check this out. Places a 30% increased speed buff for 2 turns, fills your meter by 30, and decreases the meter of enemies by 30. That's amazing. The best thing you can do in Arena is go first. That is the most important thing you can do to win a fight. So a lot of you wrote in heroes that are solid Arena heroes. For instance, you had characters like Big Un and Rashard the Tower. These heroes that are monster abilities in Arena, right? Rashard can put up a buff on all of your heroes where they don't take damage for 2 turns. And Big Un can just come in and deal amazing amounts of damage. And Ignatius can do those kind of things. And yes, those heroes are great. But the reason I kicked the previous two off of the list is because if you don't go first in Arena, those abilities are significantly less important. For instance, if you have someone like Rashard the Tower, and he has this amazing ability to put up this block damage, but he doesn't go first, and your enemy is able to stun him, or provoke him, or put him to sleep, or freeze him, or just flat out defeat him, he all of a sudden really isn't that great, because he didn't even get to go. So these heroes that mess with the turn meter are the best heroes, I think, for Arena. And not only Arena, but they can also be a huge players in dungeons, and even in Clan Boss building speed teams. So I think Lyssandra definitely deserves to be on this list because she can make your whole team go first. And that's what you're looking to do in Arena to get those wins. You have that. Her A2 also fully depletes the target's turn meter, which means you pick your biggest threat and you just completely wipe out their turn meter to make them go later. That's huge. Her A1 is solid and can transfer debuffs on her to other people. That's also a really good ability, but really it's this A3. That's what makes her amazing. Now, Arbiter is very similar. Arbiter's A3 fills the turn meters of all your allies by 30, gives a 50% increase attack, and then heals the allies as well. This is a really, really strong ability. Again, anything that can make you go first is what you're looking for. In addition to that, her speed aura is Arena in by 30%, which is a huge increase. Her A4 is also a increase in turn meter. Look at this. Revive all dead allies to 35% HP, then fills the turn meter of all allies by 20%. So you get to fill the turn meter of your living and newly revived heroes. That is amazing. That means her A4 messes with turn meters. Her A3 messes with turn meters. Her speed is an increase in the turn meters. It is amazing. And she gets to just go again if you successfully revive an ally off of her ability. This is so strong. Now, not only that, Arbiter is also strong because she is a hero that's a reward from completing your stage 4 missions, which I'll have done soon. I can't wait to do that and get Arbiter myself. But she definitely needs to be on this list for that reason. she has the ability to make your team go first. And if your team goes first, there's a really, really good chance you win the fight. And your other abilities, even though, like I said, for Shinimari, her freeze is absolutely amazing. It doesn't matter if she gets taken down before she has the ability to use it. So that's for that reason. Now, the other thing, the last hero that I want to mention is who I think should come in at number 11, just as a little bonus. I said Rey might be number 11, but I think another really great hero for that is Queen Eva. Queen Eva is a really, really great hero. She performs so well in dungeons, and she might be the best farmer in the game. Because of this ability right here, her A3, it attacks all enemies, but if you kill anybody, it resets, which means she can keep using it. She is a 7-second farmer. She's so fast at it and so good at it. And so I would put her at 11, but it's a tough call with a hero like her, but I'm going to go with 11. I think 11's a good spot for her. I think she's really, really solid hero. So that's your new list. I will put it down in the descriptions. I'll put it back up on here on the screen for a few seconds for you to check out. Now, here's the last thing. If you got something from this, hit the like and subscribe button and continue to comment on these videos so we can continue to discuss if anything needs to change in these videos, either now or in the future. We're still trying to figure this out as a team, as a community. Thank you so much for all of the support. I hope you enjoyed the video, and until next time, peace out.